Hi guys, we are in the chapter averages now. There is a question. Let's go to the question first. The score list in a particular class has been given. Rank 1 to 10, the average score is 60. Rank 1 to 6, the average is 80. Now the question asks you, what will be the rank, the average of rank 7 to 10? Alright, now I want to illustrate the difference between the sum method and the deviation method, which will help you save 20, 30, 40 seconds in every question. Alright, sum method, something that we had learned in school. What is the total average into number of values? So the total score is 600. Right, now this can be equated to first sum, that is 80 into 6 plus the second sum, which is unknown. Alright, this means that the second sum is nothing but 600 minus 480, that is 120, by which I mean the total score obtained by ranks 7, 8, 9, 10 is 120. So what will be the average? The average will be 120 by 4, that is equal to 30. So this is the sum method, something which all of us have studied in school. Alright, now if the numbers were big, if this was not 60, this was not 10, if the numbers were big, finding out the sum itself will take a bit of time. Right, you can save that time if you apply the method of deviation. Alright, so let's try to understand that. The method of deviation, the concept is net deviation from the overall average is always equal to 0. Let me explain. Just think about it. Suppose I have 2 pens and you have 4 pens. Alright. What is the average? 4 plus 2 by 2, that is 3. 6 by 2, 3. Alright. If you look at the number of pens I have, what is my deviation? I have 1 less than the average. And you have 4, you have 1 more than the average. Right. But what is the net deviation from the overall average? Plus 1, minus 1, that is equal to 0. That is the logic, and it's very commonsensical as well. An individual value can be more or less than the average, but overall deviation from the average has to be 0. Only then the average exists, right? So let us use this concept now. You won't be required to find out the sums then, alright? See, first 10, that is the overall average, is 60. What is this? This is the overall average. Right, 1 to 6 the average is 80. Okay, per head, per person, how much is this more? This is 20 more. And how many people are there? 1 to 6, there are 6 people. So total positive deviation is 120. Got the point? Deviation per head difference, right? Each person here on an average has 20 more and 6 people are there. So net positive deviation is 120. Overall deviation should be 0. So the net negative deviation for the remaining lot will be minus 120. That is the logic, right? Minus 120, and how many people are there? 4. Okay, so this becomes how much? Minus 30. So the deviation here is minus 30, right? Overall average was 60. So the average becomes 60 minus 30, that is equal to 30. You get the same answer. Let me explain once again. See, remember this, net deviation from overall average is always 0. Alright, so jitna bhi positive deviation, the same amount will be the negative deviation. So if you see the first 6 values, 20 per head into 6, the positive deviation is 120, which means for the remaining the negative deviation will be 120. Since there are 4 people, it means per head negative deviation is 30. Right, so minus 30 out of the overall average, 60 minus 30 becomes 30. So that is the answer. I hope this is clear. Thank you.